Hello, I am Dr. Kate Bono, Chair of the Department of Child and Adolescent Studies. I would like to welcome you to the 2020 Celebration of Achievement. Typically, I would be speaking to you from a stage in the Titan Student Union, where over 400 people would be gathered to celebrate the accomplishments of the amazing students of the Department of Child and Adolescent Studies. Unfortunately, we are not able to do that. However, we are still able to honor the many accomplishments of these fantastic students. We hope that instead you will gather around a computer screen or a phone or a TV and celebrate these students with this year's virtual celebration of achievement. We are certainly not professionals, but we have done our very best to put together a presentation that will allow us to honor our students while we are also staying at home. Today, you will hear about students who have achieved academically, who have participated in research projects and even presented that research at local and national conferences, who have interacted with children and families here at home and abroad through participation in community volunteering, internships, and study abroad programs, who have served other students through their participation in peer mentor programs or on our Department Student Association Board. We are so incredibly proud of all of you. I also want to acknowledge the incredibly difficult and varied circumstances that you have all faced during this spring semester as we have dealt with the challenges associated with COVID-19. Because you are passionate about improving the lives of children and families, I know that you want to be out in the world doing just that, and that you want to be together with your peers and professors during your time as a student. For some of you, this was your last semester on campus, and you certainly did not envision it to end like this. But I also know that you will learn and grow from this time in your lives. That in keeping with the theme of this year's Celebration of Achievement, innovation, that you will become innovative and creative in the ways in which you approach your work with children and families, that you will develop more empathy for those children and families when they face their own challenges in the future. I can't wait to see how you will take what you have learned during this time to positively impact the world. Make sure to come back and tell us all about it. Before we proceed with the awards, I would like to take this opportunity to say thank you. First, thank you to the family and friends who have supported the students along the way. We know that your love and support has been essential to their success. Second, I would like to thank the faculty in the Department of Child and Adolescent Studies. These faculty are always amazing, but they have really gone above and beyond over the past 2 months to support, guide, mentor, and of course teach the 1,500 students who call the Department of Child and Adolescent Studies home. And last, but certainly not least, I would like to thank everyone who participated in the creation of this virtual celebration of achievement, including CASA, the peer advisors, many faculty, and of course, the amazing CAS staff, Stephanie Ingalls and Stephanie Thames. And now, I am pleased to present a slideshow highlighting some of this year's activities in the department, produced by CASA.
Well, pick me up with golden hand. Oh, me say, oh, me tell you to run.
I'm over the same, I'm over the young. Well,
I would like to hold my little hand. I will be around, I will cry.
Everybody, see, maybe young. Well,
Casa, for that wonderful presentation. The rest of this celebration will be focused on honoring students who have either won awards or who have been involved in extracurricular activities in the department during the 2019-2020 academic year, as described by our faculty and some students from where we all are in our homes.
Hi everyone, I'm Nancy Perkins, and I'm here to present the Kimberly Perkins Award, which was created by the faculty at Cal State Fullerton in honor and memory of our daughter, a remarkable student who remained dedicated to academic excellence and continued her commitment to personal and professional development despite challenging circumstances. We certainly experienced challenges in this current situation and we all wish we could be together to celebrate all your collective accomplishments. Kimberly set a goal for herself to get her degree in child and adolescent studies and become a teacher. She let nothing get in her way, not even her fight with cancer. Sadly, she lost her battle with just one more semester to finish. I know that today she would not let a deadly virus stop her from accomplishing her goal. It is my pleasure to present this award to Diamond Bird. Diamond is a senior majoring in child and adolescent development with a minor in Spanish. She has remained focused on her academic career goals and has strived for student success as a minority student, which has been a great challenge for her. Diamond is involved in CASA, is a peer mentor, has participated in the Bold Women's Leadership Program, and has traveled to Spain and Thailand in study abroad programs. She has been on the Dean's List since the fall of 2017. As well as being a full-time student, Diamond also serves in the U.S. Army Reserves. Her discipline and determination allow her to manage her monthly training while fulfilling her academic requirements. After she graduates this month, her career goal is to be a licensed clinical social worker and provide counseling services for children of the at-risk community. It is clear that her academic excellence, leadership abilities, and community service reflect the spirit of this award. Congratulations, Diamond Bird.
The Georgia Rosen Service Award recognizes an individual who has made significant contributions to the Department of Child and Adolescent Studies and or Cal State Fullerton through unpaid endeavors. It is my pleasure to present this award to Zitlali Lizeth Cruz Roman. Zitlali serves as a mentor in the College of Health and Human Development Peer Mentor Program for the CAS Department. She began as a mentee and was remarkably inspired by her mentor, so she decided to pay it forward as a mentor herself. Zitlali empowered students to gain confidence in their abilities and helped them to develop a sense of belonging and purpose at Cal State Fullerton. Thank you, Zitlali, for your service to the CAS Department, and congratulations on this award.
Hello. The Judith V. Ramirez Early Childhood Education Award recognizes a child and adolescent development major who has demonstrated special dedication and commitment to improving the quality of services for children ages birth through five. It is my pleasure to present this award to Madeline Espinosa. Madeline, or Miss Maddie, as her students call her, has worked at the Child Development Center Preschool in Orange County for nearly a year and a half and has proven herself to be one of the center's top aides, according to her supervisor. She has consistently demonstrated her knowledge of how to create a quality classroom, incorporating evidence-based approaches as well as technology, while instilling the joy of learning in her students. Whether she is leading the kids on a jungle-themed scavenger hunt or helping them learn and write their letters as they prepare for kindergarten, Ms. Maddie enthusiastically introduces new and creative ideas into the classroom. She is admired by the children, parents, and staff. Congratulations, Madeline.
The Dedication to Children, Adolescents, and Families Award recognizes an individual who has demonstrated dedication to improving the lives of children, adolescents, and or families by her actions in accordance with knowledge derived through scientific research. This award is for either volunteer efforts or dedication above and beyond the required level in paid employment. It is my pleasure to present this award to Alondra Sanchez. Alondra was nominated by her internship supervisor, who described her as a dedicated employee with an uplifting spirit that enables the students and other staff to look at her with confidence that she has their best interests at heart. She further described Alondra as engaging and nurturing, identifying her as a future leader in child development. Congratulations, Alondra.
The Dedication to Children, Adolescents, and or Families Award in international context recognizes an individual who has demonstrated dedication to service, scholarship, and or professional development in international settings. The award may be for either volunteer activities or dedication above the required level in an international practicum course or a study abroad experience. It is my pleasure to present this award to Melanie Asensio. Melanie has been part of every aspect of the CAS Study Abroad program for the past 2 years. She has helped with recruitment efforts, provided leadership to new cohorts, and helped developing class materials to improve the experience of students traveling abroad. Melanie joined the Costa Rica program in the spring 2019 and the Thailand program in the fall 2019 as well, where she implemented lesson plans for children ages 0 to 12. She was planning to go to Costa Rica yet again before the pandemic hit. Yet it is her contributions as a co-author for a Teen Mom Success Stories booklet for inspiring young mothers here and abroad that makes me the most proud. Through her hard work, creativity, and persistence, Melanie has and will continue to leave a mark in children's life here and abroad. Congratulations, Melanie.
The Robert B. McLaren Award in Children's Moral Development recognizes a child and adolescent development major who's made contributions in scholarship or practice to the moral education and character development of children or adolescents. This can be demonstrated through things like relevant scholarly or creative work, or through the implementation of a program that fosters moral education and character development among children or youth in settings like childcare settings, religious institutions, organized youth groups, or school settings. It is with great pleasure that I present this award to Tiana Bowler. Tiana was really a wonderful choice for this award because of the contributions she's made through her church to mentoring young people. So for the past nearly 3 years, she's met twice a week with ninth grade girls to lead discussions and conversations that reflect on real-world issues in relation to their Christian faith and to the Bible. And Tiana describes in her application how she doesn't just want to teach about, you know, the perspectives offered through the Bible, but she also wants to create a space where the kids themselves, the teenage girls, are allowed to, you know, share their own thoughts, share their own perspectives. And I love this because we know that when working with teens, it's really important that we listen to them. So this is just one example of how Tiana has taken what she's learned in the classroom and applied it to really support young people's moral development and really to help build their character. Congratulations, Tiana.
The Outstanding Junior Award recognizes the junior level student in Child and Adolescent Studies who exemplifies the highest standards of scholarship, service to the community and or university, and commitment to education. It is my pleasure to present this award to Presley Moffitt. Presley is a committed student to her academics by maintaining a cumulative GPA of 3.73, as well as being involved in many activities and organizations on campus. Presley is a member of the CASA Club, she's a peer advisor, and she is the secretary of the SCTA, Student California Teachers Association. She also finds time to volunteer and complete service assignments at Orangewood Children's Home and other activities arranged by CASA. Presley is comfortable in the role of the peer advisor, and in a very short time, she already displays a sense of mastery in this new role. Presley is very deserving of this award. Congratulations. The James Gilmore Outstanding Senior Award recognizes the senior level student in Child and Adolescent Studies who exemplifies the highest standards of scholarship, service to the community and or university, and commitment to education. It is my pleasure to present this award to Tiana Bowler. Tiana is a committed student to her academics by maintaining a cumulative GPA of 3.65, as well as being involved in many activities and organizations on campus. Tiana is receiving this award due to her scholarship and service to the community. Tiana is a very dedicated advocate for students, and she's a mentor at her local church and serves 5th grade to 12th grade every Wednesday and Sunday. The curriculum that she utilizes serves to foster moral development and allows young participants to open up and share about their struggles. The program also helps in the Fullerton community through projects at Commonwealth Elementary and Love Fullerton Day. Lastly, Tiana is a peer advisor for the major advisement team, and she has supported this program for over 3 years. Tiana is very deserving of this award. Congratulations.
To be eligible for graduation cum laude, undergraduate students must have achieved a grade point average of at least 3.5 in all collegiate coursework. These students wear a medallion with a white ribbon at graduation. It is my pleasure to recognize the following students who have achieved this honor. To be eligible for graduation magna cum laude, undergraduate students must have achieved a grade point average of at least 3.75 in all collegiate coursework. These students wear a medallion with an orange ribbon at graduation. It is my pleasure to recognize the following students who have achieved this honor. To be eligible for graduation summa cum laude, undergraduate students must have achieved a grade point average of 3.9 or higher in all collegiate coursework. These students wear a medallion with a blue ribbon signifying highest honors at graduation. It is my pleasure to recognize the following students who have achieved this honor.
Jumpstart is a national nonprofit organization working towards the day that every child in America enters kindergarten ready to succeed. At Cal State Fullerton, Jumpstart is a joint service learning program with the Center for Internships and Community Engagement and the Department of Child and Adolescent Studies. Over the course of the academic school year, Jumpstart members earn 300 hours of service working in preschool classrooms in under-resourced communities within Santa Ana Unified School District and Anaheim Elementary School District. Twice a week, these Jumpstart teams lead two-hour lessons within the preschool classroom, as well as spending additional time supporting children and teachers in their learning. Most of the Jumpstart members here at Cal State Fullerton also serve as AmeriCorps members. It is my pleasure to recognize the student participants of the 2019-2020 Jumpstart program.
The Child and Adolescent Studies Student Association, CASA, helps students develop leadership skills, professional skills, and knowledge of child and adolescent development, as well as provide opportunities to interact with fellow students and faculty in an atmosphere that fosters social networking.
The three principal activities that CASA focuses on are community service, professional development, and social activities. As the faculty advisors for CASA, we have had the pleasure of witnessing how CASA members make positive contributions to the CSUF campus and the community at large.
CASA has remained in good standing for numerous years and is a model of diversity, social responsibility, collaboration, and strong ethics. We are so proud of the good work that CASA does each and every year, especially this year with the unprecedented challenges posed by COVID-19 pandemic.
They seamlessly and creatively transition their activities online, continuing to provide opportunities for students to come together through Zoom socials, virtual speakers and panels, and online donation drives. It is our pleasure to recognize CASA executive board members under the exceptional leadership of CASA President Jennifer Garcia.
Hi everyone, my name is Jennifer Garcia and I serve as your CASA president for 2019 to 2020. Every year, the Child and Adolescent Studies Student Association, otherwise known as CASA, has done an extraordinary job of helping and giving to our community. This year, CASA has completed over 120 hours of community service and events. That included assisting local elementary schools prepare for school carnivals, creating smiles for children in foster care homes and hospitals. CASA has participated in walks that contribute to raising funds for children with autism and benefiting families with those with leukemia. This is only a glimpse of what CASA has done through this academic year. Thank you to all the members who made these events possible. Thank you to the executive board who has worked hard since last summer to prepare for everything we have accomplished. Tonight, we recognize our members and board members. I gladly introduce you to the CASA Executive Board of 2019 to 2020. As our membership manager, we have Alexis Flores. As our information manager, we have
Kaylee Fisher. As our finance manager, we have Edward Reyna. As our professional and career development, we have Brianna Gonzalez. As our event and activities manager, we have Melanie Asensio. As our inner club council representative, we have Sabrina Flores. For our two community project managers, we have Destiny Juarez and Kaylee Fisher. As our vice president, we have Jade Lee. As our executive president, we have Jennifer Garcia. Our two advisors are Dr. Claudia Pineda and Dr. Michelle Ramos. Without them, CASA would not be where it is. Now, our membership manager, Alexis Flores, will congratulate our members for their hard work.
Thank you, Jennifer. I am honored to present the CORD recipients. CORD recipients are individuals who have earned between 20 through 49 hours through CASA, including community service, event attendance, fundraisers, and socials. Please help me in congratulating the following members. Next, we have our CORD and SASH recipients. CORD and SASH are members who have earned more than 50 hours through CASA, including community service, event attendance, fundraisers, leadership, and social hours. Please help me in congratulating the following members.
The Peer Mentor Program is part of a college-wide effort in building learning partnerships between students. We had a small, selected group of peer mentors who worked closely with 3 to 6 students across the last year to help them academically and personally. For example, the mentors helped students to identify resources across campus, achieve their semester goals, or simply pass along their tips on how to find parking on campus after 10 a.m., which is incredibly difficult. The following students were peer mentors during the past academic year.
The peer advisors are selected by the department to assist the advisement team with additional support. The support includes helping students with planning course schedules, sharing student-to-student experiences, discussing the major or minor and options to new, transfer, or prospective students, as well as providing walk-in office hours. They're involved in the summer orientations and also work in the CAS department office. These students are a valuable part of the advisement team, and we are very fortunate to have them. The following students were peer advisors during the past academic year. Seniors graduating Spring 20, Tiana Bowler, Melanie Asensio, and Citlali Cruz Roman. And returning in the fall, Risa Lavelle, Presley Moffitt, Madai Gill, and Miranda Simon. Thanks for all your help.
Working towards their degree in the science of child development, CAS students learn to access, understand, and apply relevant scientific research to help children and families.
We now honor those students who have chosen to take a step further by directly engaging in research themselves, assisting with faculty research, or conducting their own supervised projects.
CAS course assistants are students who have already successfully completed a course in the major and serve students in the classroom by helping them with mastery of course material. They provide assistance through discussion, practice, and study tips. The following students were CAS course assistants during the last academic year.
Academic achievement is recognized each fall and spring semester for undergraduate students who, for a minimum of 12 units of graded coursework, earn a GPA of 3.5 or better. This is indicated by representation on the Dean's List. It is my pleasure to recognize the following students who are on the Dean's List in the spring and the fall of 2019.
Thank you.
Congratulations to all of you who have been recognized in the 2020 Virtual Celebration of Achievement. Now that we have honored the students, some of the students would like to honor those that have supported them, their families, friends, and faculty. Thank you, students, for sending in those wonderful slides. Before I close, I would like to take a moment to recognize the graduating class of 2020. Just over 500 students are graduated from Cal State Fullerton with a degree in child and adolescent development this year. In a couple of weeks, CSUF will host a virtual commencement celebration. I hope you will join that event. For now, we would like to share some photos of the class of 2020. Congratulations, we are proud of you. We know you will do great things. This concludes the 2020 Virtual Celebration of Achievement for the Department of Child and Adolescent Studies. Thank you so much for joining us. Take care of yourselves and each other. We can't wait until we can all be on campus together again.